So there's a lot of attention on the U.S.-China economic relationship. It's one of the largest bilateral trading relationships in the world. It's about $650 billion in two-way trade, but it's a pretty imbalanced number. You have about $170 billion of U.S. exports that go into China and about $480 billion of Chinese exports that come into the U.S. So you've got a significant gap in terms of the volume of exports versus imports between the two countries. And so that imbalance, among other factors, has been a reason why there's been tensions over the years as China has grown. What we find with our clients all around the world is that they're very focused on this relationship. And so what you hear a lot about and a lot of attention is focused on is the potential imposition of tariffs on the trade in goods in an effort to try to find balance. The part that actually doesn't get as much attention, but I think is worth as much focus as the trading relationship, is the investment relationship. And that's for a couple of reasons. One is because typically as two countries develop closer and closer trading ties, those trading ties begin to develop into and lead into more bilateral investment. Now there has been a significant expansion of bilateral investment between the US and China, but it's been limited and slow in coming. But when it has occurred, it's actually created jobs and made a difference in terms of the two-way trade. But the investment's important, particularly for the US. We're a huge exporter of services. And if you're going to export services, you need to have people on the ground. You have to have operations in the country in which you're selling your services. And it requires an ability to be able to invest in that market. But it's also important because a lot of high-end goods that the United States sells, a lot of our manufactured goods that we sell, aren't simple products that you can stick in a boat and send across a border. You actually physically have to have an infrastructure of support and servicing in order to sell the good. And so to the extent to which the tensions between the US and China impede further investment, it actually frustrates the goal of the US policymakers because it becomes harder for the US to sell the things that it has a comparative advantage in. Now, of course, you have to remember that as much as the bilateral economic relationship defines a lot of how the US and China deal with each other, there's so much more at stake. Geopolitical issues, global development issues, environmental issues. There's a broad agenda between two really important countries that have a lot of interests in common. So however one assesses what's happening currently in terms of the noise on trade issues, it's likely that the resolution will be one in which both sides will work very hard to find a mutually beneficial outcome, and they'll find a way to maintain strong cooperative relations on trade going forward.